Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn about igneous rocks. What are igneous rocks? What is their composition and different forms of igneous rocks? So let us start. Igneous rocks are generally the rocks that are formed by cooling and solidification of magma. We all know what is magma, and if you don't know, then I will tell you later in later videos. Okay, magma is basically a molten material that is found inside volcanoes or inside the surface. So the rocks that are formed by the cooling and solidification of magma are called igneous rocks. The example can be granite, basalt and many more. Composition, what is the composition of igneous rocks? So these are the composition of igneous rocks: silicon oxide, aluminium oxide, calcium, magnesium and ferrous or iron, you can say. So silicon oxide is present in weight percent by 40 to 75%, aluminium oxide by 10 to 20%, and the remaining is covered up by calcium, magnesium and ferrous. So this is the composition of igneous rocks. Now moving to the forms of igneous rocks. So there are two forms of igneous rocks: extrusive bodies and intrusive bodies. Extrusive bodies and intrusive bodies are further divided into discordant and concordant. Okay, discordant are further divided, discordant of extrusive are divided into two more categories. One contains dikes, ring dike, cone sheet, and the other contains batholith, ethmolith, harpolith, conolith. And concordant contains sills, lagolith, lobolith, bismolith, and the other contain phacolith. And intrusives, discordant contains volcanic neck. That's it. So now let us know what is form. Form is shape and size of igneous rock. That is called form. Okay. So we learned about extrusive bodies and intrusive bodies. There are two kinds of form. Extrusive bodies. What are extrusive bodies? When magma comes out of Earth's surface, it is called lava. And the bodies that are formed due to solidification of lava are called extrusive bodies. Okay, are called EB means extrusive bodies. And intrusive bodies, when magma crystallized under Earth's surface, it is called intrusive body. Now we will know the further extrusive bodies. Inside that there was discordant body and their subtypes. So what are the discordant body? Discordant body are the bodies which cut through overlying strata or pre-existing rocks. Means suppose this was a pre-existing rock and it came cutting this body came cutting out this, means cut this, and the body, one body, suppose this body cut the overlying strata, then this body will be called as discordant body. Its subtypes are dikes, ring dike, cone sheet. This one is the first classification. What are dikes? Dikes are wall-like igneous bodies that cut through country rock. Or country rock are those rocks, means pre-existing rocks are called country rock. So these are the, see, this is a wall-like structure that is cutting this country rock. Okay, this wall-like structure. So this structure is called dike. In between this is dike. This is igneous mass basically. What is ring dike? A dike that has circular outcrop. Suppose there is a dike and its outcrop here is circular, then it will be called as ring dike. Okay, circular or arc like structure is, that is called ring dike. Okay, outcrop, you know, the rock mass that stand above the surface. Cone sheets, inward dipping dike like masses with circular outcrop. See, this is the inward dipping, means it is dipping inside the earth. And it is circular also. A circular outcrop, that is inward dipping. Inward dipping dike with a circular outcrop. Means this will have circular outcrop, but the dike is inward dipping. That's why it is called cone sheet. Now the second categorization is, in this there are four. Batholith. Largest intrusive bodies extending to unknown depth are called batholiths. And batholiths of small dimension are called stalks. And stalks of circular outcrop. Stalks, and that those stalks that are having a circular outcrop are called bosses. Okay, what is ethmolith? Funnel shaped basic bodies with circular outcrop. These will be like this structure, and that are called ethmolite. They are basically funnel shape. What is a funnel shape? This is a funnel. Okay. Then harpolith, sickle shaped basic bodies with circular outcrop, and the bodies that are sickle shaped, this is a sickle shape, that are called harpolith. What is conolith? Irregular intrusive body, means it will not have any fixed shape. Deep seated intrusive body, irrespective of shape and size, is called pluton. These are the deep seated intrusive body, means whose shape and size are not fixed, are called pluton. Now the second type is concordant body. In this there are many other many subtypes. So what is a concordant body? A concordant body lie between rock beds and run parallel to structure of country rock. These lie between the rock beds. Suppose this is a rock bed and this is a rock bed, and the body that lie between them is called concordant body. Igneous mass that lie between them is called concordant body. So these are its subtypes are sills. Sills are basically seed-like igneous body which run parallel to bedding plane. This is a bedding plane, and this black mass is called igneous mass, and it is running parallel to this bedding plane. So then this is called sill. Lacolith, lens-shaped igneous body which run parallel. Sorry, lens-shaped igneous body cause overlying bed to arc in form of dome. See, this shaded portion is igneous mass here. Means magma, and it is causing the overlying bed to arc in the shape of a dome. It is forming a arc shape, and this shape is called dome when it is in 3D. So that is called lacolith. What is lopolith? This is saucer shaped. You can say it is, this shape is like a saucer. Okay, saucer shaped body which is bent downward, and it is bent in downward direction into a basin like shape, is called a lopolith. What is bismuth? Sometimes what happens, magma break through over, suppose this is an overlying rock bed, and magma break it and comes out of this, and then the magma consolidates, and this consolidated part is called bismuth. What is a facolith? Crescent shaped igneous bodies occurring at crest or trough of fold. Suppose this is a fold, and these are, this shaded portion are the igneous masses. Okay, and these are in shape of a crescent. Crescent means like a crescent moon. Okay, then this structure is called facolith. This igneous body is called facolith. Now we are going to discuss the second portion, that is extrusive. What is extrusive? Extrusive, we have already learned that. This one. Oh, sorry, it should be intrusive, because extrusive we have learned. Intrusive, when magma crystallize beneath earth's surface, then the bodies are called intrusive body. Okay, these were the types of extrusive, and this is intrusive, not IX, it is INTRUSIVE, intrusive. Okay, in this concordant, lava flows and pyroclast are material that comes out of volcano. Lava flows and pyroclasts, which are products of volcanic activities, are called concordant bodies. And discordant, in discordant, volcanic neck is the part. Mass of igneous rock produced by consolidation of lava and pyroclastic material in channel of eruption of extinct volcano. Suppose this is a extinct volcano, and this is its channel, means its way. Here, the consolidation of lava and pyroclast take place, and this material is called volcanic neck. Okay. So thank you for watching this video. Hope you liked this video.